Hi students, today we will discuss about polyhalogen compounds. What are the polyhalogen compounds? The compounds which contains two or more than two compounds, they are known as polyhalogen compounds. So in that we will discuss about that dihalogen compound, trihalogen compounds and tetrahalogen compounds. Let us discuss about that dihalogen compounds. The compounds which contains two halogens are known as dihalogen compounds. The compounds which contains two halogens are known as dihalogen compounds. These dihalogen compounds further classifies into two types. One is geminal dihalides, second one is vicinal dihalides. We are already discussed about that. What about that geminal dihalides? It means if two similar groups are present on same carbon atom is known as geminal dihalides. It means here two chlorine atoms are present on same carbon atom, it is considered as a geminal dihalides. Geminal dihalides commonly known as alkylidine halides. Generally it is considered as a alkylidine halides. Now vicinal halides. What are the vicinal halides? Vicinal dihalides. If two similar groups present an adjacent carbon, each one is known as vicinal dihalides. Common name for this vicinal dihalides is alkylene halides. So preparation methods. How geminal dihalides are prepared? Preparation methods. From alkyne. From alkyne. When ethane reacts with HBr, your hydrogen is added to one carbon and bromine is added to another carbon after the breaking of one pi bond. So what is the compound we can obtain? Vinyl bromide we can obtain. These vinyl bromide reacts with one mole of HBr. So your Markovnikov rule is takes place. According to Markovnikov rule, hydrogen is added to that carbon which is having more the number of hydrogen and bromine is added to that carbon which is having less number of hydrogen after the breaking of double bond. So what is the compound we can obtain? 1,1 dibromoethane we can obtain. Now here vicinal dihalides. Preparation method. How they are prepared? Same from alkyne, it means from ethane. When ethane reacts with HBr, hydrogen is added to one carbon and bromine is added to another carbon after the breaking of one pi bond. So vinyl bromide we can obtain. This vinyl bromide when it is reacts with HBr in presence of peroxides, benzyl peroxide. So here reaction is takes place according to anti-Markovnikov rule. It means bromine is added to this carbon and hydrogen added to this carbon. So what is the compound we can obtain? 1,2 dibromoethane we can obtain. 1,2 dibromoethane, here 1,1 dibromoethane is obtained. So it is one of the preparatory method from alkynes for geminal dihalides and vicinal dihalides. Next go for that one more preparation method. From carbonyl compounds. When aldehyde reacts with PCl5. Here oxygen atom is replaced by two halogens. Then phosphorus is removed in the form of POCl3. POCl3 is one of the best living group. Ketones. Ketone, when it is reacts with PCl5, oxygen is replaced by two halogens. POCl3. So when aldehyde reacts with PCl5, here chlorines are present on terminal carbon. If ketones are reacts with PCl5, chlorines are present on internal carbon. So this is one of the preparatory method for the preparation of geminal dihalides. What about that vicinal dihalides? When ethene reacts with bromine in presence of CCl4, addition reaction is takes place. So in that addition reaction, we can obtain 1,2-dibromoethane. We can obtain 1,2-dibromoethane. We can obtain. So these are the preparation methods for geminal dihalides and vicinal dihalides. Now go for chemical properties. Chemical properties of vicinal dihalides and geminal dihalides. So here, geminal dihalides. Geminal dihalides. Here, vicinal dihalides. First chemical properties. Reaction with aqueous NaOH. Reaction with aqueous NaOH. When geminal dihalides reacts with aqueous NaOH, here two chlorine atoms are replaced by OH groups. This is the compound we can obtain. Then 2 moles of NaCl. If two OH groups are present, if more than one OH groups are present on same carbon atom, it is highly unstable, so it undergoes dehydration. We can obtain aldehydes. If halogens are present on terminal carbon, when it is reacts with aqueous NaOH, it gives aldehydes. It gives aldehydes. Similarly, if halogens are present on internal carbon, when it is reacts with aqueous NaOH, here chlorine atoms are replaced by OH group. We are already discussed about that. If more than one OH group are present on same carbon, it is highly unstable, undergoes dehydration. We can obtain ketone. We can obtain ketone. Ketones we can obtain. If two halogens are present on terminal carbon, it reacts with aqueous NaOH, gives aldehydes. If two halogens are present on internal carbon, when it is reacts with aqueous NaOH, gives ketones. Whereas in vicinal dihalides, reaction with aqueous NaOH. For example, 1,2-dichloroethane. This 1,2-dichloroethane, when it is reacts with aqueous NaOH, here chlorine atoms are replaced by OH group. So what is the compound we can obtain? Ethane 1,2-diol. Ethane 1,2-diol we can obtain. What is the common name for that? Ethylene glycol. So ethane 1,2-diol we can obtain. This is about that reaction with aqueous NaOH. Next, second reaction is reaction with KCN. what are the compounds we can obtain? Reaction with KCN. When geminal dihalides reacts with alcoholic KCl, when it is reacts with alcoholic KCl, your chlorine atoms are replaced by cyanide groups. Then 2 moles of KCl is removed. Here also, when it is reacts with KCl, reaction with KCN, 1,2-dichloroethane. When 1,2-dichloroethane reacts with KCN in presence of alcohol, your chlorine atoms are replaced by cyanide. This is the compound we can obtain. This cyanide compound, when it is undergoes hydrolysis, what is the compound we can obtain? When it is undergoes hydrolysis, your cyanide undergoes hydrolysis, we can obtain carboxylic acids. We can obtain carboxylic acid. Here also, when it is undergoes hydrolysis, what are the compounds we can obtain? Carboxylic acids we can obtain. Carboxylic acids we can obtain. Reaction with zinc. When 2 moles of alkyl halides, it means geminal dihalides, reacts with zinc metal in presence of dry ether, your totally zinc halide is removed. Then after we can obtain alkenes. Higher alkenes we can obtain. Higher alkenes and symmetrical alkenes we can obtain by this reaction. Here also third reaction is reaction with zinc. When it is reacts with alcoholic zinc, here zinc chloride is removed. It means dehalogenation reaction is takes place. When dehalogenation reaction is takes place, we can obtain alkenes. We can obtain alkenes. So here alkenes we can obtain. Zinc and alcohol. Alcoholic zinc is act as a dehalogenating agent. In both the cases, dehalogenation is takes place. We can obtain alkenes. Fourth reaction is reaction with sodamide. Sodamide or alcoholic KOH. Reaction with NaNH2. Or alcoholic KOH, dehydrohalogenation reaction is takes place. When geminal dihalides reacts with NaNH2, your dehydrohalogenation is takes place. There are 2 moles of HCl molecules are removed. Then after, what is the compound we can obtain? Ethyne we can obtain. What is the compound we can obtain? Ethyne compound we can obtain. 2 moles of NaCl plus 2 moles of ammonia. This is the compound we can obtain, ethyne. Here also same. Fourth reaction is reaction with sodamide. Vicinal dihalides, when reacts with sodamide. Dehydrohalogenation takes place. In that also, triple bond will be formed in between two carbon atoms. If you take 2 moles, 2 moles of sodium chloride plus 2 moles of ammonia we can obtain. Here also ethane. In both the cases, same product we can obtain. So when geminal dihalides or vicinal dihalides reacts with NaNH2, this reaction is involves in dehydrohalogenation. In that dehydrohalogenation, we can obtain, first of all, we can obtain alkene. After the dehydrohalogenation, directly we can obtain alkynes. Now go for the trihalogen compounds. What are the trihalogen compounds? Compounds contain 3 halogen atoms, are known as trihalogen compounds. So in this class we will discuss about that halo form. CHF3, CHCl3, CHBr3, CHI3. This is chloroform. Chloroform, bromoform, iodoform. All these are the colorless liquids. Only iodoform is a yellow crystalline compound. Now chloroform. Chloroform, it was introduced by Liebig. Chloroform was introduced by Liebig. The name chloroform was given by Dumas. Why the name is given chloroform? Why? Because this chloroform, when it is subjected to hydrolysis, we can obtain formic acid. So due to the formation of formic acid, it is considered as a chloroform, chlorine containing compound, and further hydrolysis gives formic acid. So that's why it is considered as a chloroform. And what about the structure? Structure of haloform. It is having distorted tetrahedral structure. Here all the haloforms having distorted tetrahedral structure. Why? Because all the atoms are not in equal. So that's why it is having distorted tetrahedral structure. Now let us discuss about the preparation methods of chloroform and haloforms. First one is from methane. How chloroform is prepared from methane? Simple thing. When methane reacts with chlorine in presence of sunlight, we are already discussed about that. When it is reacts with sunlight, here hydrogen and chlorine removed in the form of HCl, then methyl chloride we can obtain. This reaction is involves in free radical substitution reaction. Methyl chloride is obtained. This methyl chloride reacts with another mole of chlorine. Here dichloromethane we can obtain. This dichloromethane reacts with another mole of chlorine. We can obtain chloroform as one of the product. And when it is reacts with chlorine, your carbon tetrachloride we can obtain. So this method is not used for the preparation of chloroform. Why? Because it gives a mixture of chloromethanes. So that's why this method is not in used. Second one is from carbon tetrachloride. your CCl4 undergoes reduction in presence of iron and H2O. In presence of iron and H2O, your reduction is takes place when chlorine atom is replaced by hydrogen. We can obtain chloroform as a product from chloral hydrate. Third reaction is from chloral hydrate. What is chloral hydrate? We are already discussed about that chloral. Chloral. Trichloroacetaldehyde. Trichloroacetaldehyde is considered as a chloral. This chloral compound is highly soluble in water, even though it is organic compound. Organic compounds are generally insoluble in water, but this chloral is highly soluble in water because due to the formation of hydrogen bonds. Little bit partial attractions are takes place in between hydrogen and chlorine. So due to the formation of this hydrogen bond, this chloral hydrate is highly soluble in water and highly stable. So what is the compound we can obtain? CCl3CHOH taken twice. This is considered as a chloral hydrate. Chloral hydrate contain two OH group. Even though it contains two OH groups, it is highly stable. Why? Because due to the formation of hydrogen bond. We are already discussed before this topic, if the carbon contain more than one OH group, it is highly unstable. It undergoes dehydration, gives remaining products. What are the products are formed here? But here this carbon contain two OH group, but it is highly stable. Why? Because due to the formation of hydrogen bond. This chloral hydrate, when it is reacts with base, when it is reacts with base, so what is the compound we can obtain? Here chloroform we can obtain. HCOONa, sodium formate and H2. This is the product we can obtain. So in that we can obtain chloroform as a major product. And the fourth one is haloform reaction. It is one of the most important reaction. Most of the time this question is given in entrance point of view. In which of the following compound gives iodoform reaction, or in which of the following compound gives chloroform reaction, like that questions are asked generally. So it is one of the most important thing. So haloform reaction. Haloform reaction. So what are the compounds gives this haloform reaction? Alcohols and carbonyl compounds gives haloform reaction. So in that alcohol, the primary alcohol, only ethyl alcohol gives this reaction, and the remaining secondary alcohol, in that OH group is present on second end carbon, that gives haloform reaction. And the carbonyl compounds, the carbonyl compounds which are having methyl keto group, they gives haloform reaction. So what is the note point for this? What are the compounds gives haloform reaction? Simple note point is the compounds which contains methyl keto group. The compounds which contain methyl keto group, they reacts with halogen in presence of base. We can obtain haloform, or it gives haloform reaction. The compound which contains CH3CO group, or compound on oxidation, the compound on oxidation gives methyl keto group. This shows haloform reaction. The compound which contain methyl keto group, or the compound which undergoes oxidation and gives methyl keto group, they gives haloform reaction. So in that, first of all, ethyl alcohol. From ethyl alcohol. So when ethyl alcohol ethyl alcohol subjected to bleaching powder distillation. What is the compound we can obtain? CHCl3 we can obtain. HCOON we can obtain. Okay, if it is calcium, no? This is the compound we can obtain, and hydrogen halides we can obtain. Miss? Now I will give you the mechanism. Mechanism for this reaction. CaOCl2, when it is reacts with water molecule, what is the compound we can obtain? Here, nascent chlorines are obtained. In further reaction, when ethyl alcohol reacts with nascent chlorine, here alpha hydrogens are removed and it undergoes oxidation, we can obtain acetaldehyde, 2 moles of HCl. So here chlorine is act as a oxidizing agent. Here chlorine is act as a oxidizing agent. So aldehydes we can obtain. This aldehyde, when it is reacts with chlorine, 3 moles of chlorine, here alpha hydrogens are replaced by chlorines, we can obtain chloral. What is the compound we can obtain? Chloral we can obtain. This chloral, when it is reacts with CaOH or any one of the base, CaOH taken twice, you have to take 2 moles. So what is the compound we can obtain? 2 moles of chloroform, then calcium formate we can obtain. So here the chloroform is obtained. This is the reaction is takes place. Here the chlorines which are, here the chlorine is act as an oxidizing agent, here the chlorines are act as a substituent, it means chlorinating agents. Chlorinating. Here chlorine is act as an oxidizing agent, here chlorine is act as a chlorinating agent. Now next go for that from aldehydes, carbonyl compounds. When acetaldehyde reacts with iodine and NaOH, what is the compound we can obtain? Here, CHI3, iodoform, HCOONa plus sodium iodide and H2O. These are the compounds we can obtain. Now see the mechanism. First of all, base is attacks. This alpha hydrogen is removed. Then carbanion we can obtain. So formation of carbanion. Now this carbanion attacks on iodine. Alpha iodo acetaldehyde we can obtain and I minus. Again, this compound reacts with base. Again, here alpha hydrogen is removed. Carbanion we can obtain. Carbanion is obtained. So this carbanion is further attacks on another mole of iodine. I minus is removed, CHI2 diiodoacetaldehyde we can obtain. This diiodoacetaldehyde having one more alpha hydrogen, so base is attacks on alpha hydrogen, then carbene ion is obtained. This carbene ion is attacks on iodine, Ci3CHO I-. Now, in the next step, triiodoacetaldehyde, when it is reacts with OH-, it acts as a nucleophile. Why? Because it is having strong electron withdrawing group. Your CX3 group is act as a strong electron withdrawing group. So due to that strong electron withdrawing nature, this carbon having more partial positive charge. So due to the presence of high partial positive charge on carbon, your OH group is act as a nucleophile, and when OH group is attacks on this, your pi electrons are shifted towards the oxygen. Then what is the compound we can obtain? Ci3CH OH. Now, when these pi electrons are shifted towards the carbon, and this Ci3 along with shared pair of electron removed in the form of Ci3-, then HCOOH, formic acid we can obtain. Exchange of proton is takes place. So due to that exchange of proton, your iodo form we can obtain, and HCOO- iodo form we can obtain. So this is the mechanism for the formation of haloform or iodo form. The important note point for that haloform reaction: what are the compounds gives haloform reaction? First one is primary alcohol, it means only ethyl alcohol gives haloform reaction. Secondary alcohol in which OH functional group is present on second end carbon. They gives iodoform test. It means they must having ethyl group like this. Tertiary alcohol, no haloform reaction. Why? Because they undergoes oxidation, they does not use methyl keto group, so that's why tertiary alcohol does not use haloform reaction. And fourth one is aldehydes, carbonyl compounds in that aldehydes only acetaldehyde gives iodoform reaction. The remaining aldehydes does not gives. Why? Because remaining aldehydes, only acetaldehyde gives haloform reaction. Why? Because only acetaldehyde contains methyl keto group or halogen substituted acetaldehyde, like this. Halogen substituted, mono-iodo, di-iodo, tri-iodo, acetaldehydes, whatever it may be. These are the compounds gives iodoform, it means haloform reaction. And the fifth point is ketones. What are the ketones? In ketones, CO functional group must be present at second end. It means this is the keto group. In ketones, if CO functional group is present at second position, from that end at second position is present, it contains methyl keto group, they gives haloform reaction. It means the compounds which are contains methyl keto group or the compounds undergoes oxidation gives methyl keto group, they gives haloform reaction. These are the important note points, and these are the four type of compounds can give haloform reaction. And what are the reagents are given for that haloform reaction? Generally examiner asked, these are the following types of reagents. These are the following types of reagents are asked by examiner in that exam paper. Chlorine NaOH, second one is iodine NaOH or bromine NaOH, like that. Then after bleaching powder CaOCl2 and calcium hydroxide and chlorine. When calcium hydroxide reacts with chlorine, again we can obtain bleaching powder only. So bleaching powder, when it is undergoes hydrolysis, again we can obtain calcium hydroxide and chlorine gas. And sodium hypoiodide, how it is obtained? When NaOH reacts with iodine, we can obtain sodium hypoiodide or iodine with base. These are the reagents are given. Now test your knowledge. You see the questions, totally 20 questions are given. In which of the following compound gives iodoform test? It means haloform test. So first compound, is it gives haloform test? No. Why? Because there is no methyl keto group. Just keep in your mind, the compounds without or with oxidation gives methyl keto group. They reacts with halogen in presence of base gives haloform reaction. So it does not contain methyl keto group, so it does not gives. And what about that second one? Second one is tertiary alcohol. We are already discussed about that tertiary alcohol does not gives any haloform reaction. And here this compound contain methyl keto group, it means it is one of the ketone. Here keto functional group is present at a second position, so it gives. And what about this? Here there is no methyl keto group, so it does not gives. What about this? It gives iodoform reaction. Why? Because it contain methyl keto group. Okay. And what about this? This is primary alcohol, ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol, when it is undergoes oxidation, we can obtain acetaldehyde. So it contains methyl keto group, so it is also gives iodoform test. Now what about this seventh one? Here secondary alcohol, the two OH group is, OH functional group is present on second end carbon. Further it is also oxidation. On oxidation, what is the compound we can obtain? Methyl keto group. So it is also contain methyl keto group, so it gives iodoform test. What about this? Here functional group, OH group is present on third carbon. When it is undergoes oxidation, it does not gives methyl keto group, so it does not gives haloform reaction. Aldehyde, in that aldehyde only acetaldehyde gives iodoform reaction, it means haloform reaction. The remaining aldehyde does not gives, so it does not gives. Now what about this? Carboxylic acids, amides, acid halides, esters and acid anhydrides, all these compounds contain methyl keto group, but these are the compounds does not gives iodoform reaction. Why these are the compound does not gives iodoform reaction? Why? Because they contain best leaving groups. They contain best leaving groups. So here nucleophile is attacks on this carbonyl carbon. This nucleophile is attacks on carbonyl carbon. So these are the best leaving group. So they does not gives iodoform reaction. It is one of the most important thing. Carboxylic acids, amides, acid halides and esters and acid anhydrides, these are the compounds, even though they contain methyl keto group, they does not gives any haloform reaction. Why? Because they contain best leaving groups. Here benzaldehyde, benzaldehyde does not contain any methyl keto group, so it does not gives. What about this? It contains methyl keto group, so it gives iodoform reaction. Now here the 17th one, it is one of the important thing. How? When ethyl acetate first of all undergoes base hydrolysis, what is the compound we can obtain? Here sodium acetate and ethyl alcohol we can obtain. So now after that hydrolysis we can obtain ethyl alcohol. So this ethyl alcohol further reacts with iodine in presence of base, we can obtain iodoform reaction. So only ethyl esters gives haloform reactions. Now come to that 18th one, it is also one of the important thing. Here methyl keto group, active methylene group. So the carbon which is the methylene group which is attached with two electron withdrawing group is known as sandwich carbon or active methylene group. This active methylene group contains more acidic hydrogens. So due to that presence of more acidic hydrogen, it is also reacts with iodine and NaOH gives iodoform reaction. Now what about that methyl alcohol? Methyl alcohol does not contain methyl keto group, so that's why it does not gives. What about this? Here iodine substituted aldehydes, acetaldehyde. Iodine substituted acetaldehyde gives, or halogen substituted acetaldehyde gives haloform reaction. This is the compound gives iodoform reaction. Just go through this, and it is one of the most important question. Every time this question is repeated in several competitive exams. In which of the following compound gives iodoform test? And here this iodoform test is also used, or a haloform test is used to distinguish some compounds also. So preparation methods are over. Now let us go for that physical properties. Physical properties. Fluoroform, chloroform, bromoform, iodoform. Chloroform, fluoroform, chloroform and bromoform, these are colorless liquids, but iodoform is a yellow color. Crystalline compound. Here they are having sweet smell. Dipole moment. What is the dipole moment order? CHCl3, CHF3, CHBr3. CHI3. So chloroform having more dipole moment than fluoroform, fluoroform having more dipole moment than bromoform, bromoform having more dipole moment than iodoform. Your important thing is, why fluoroform having less dipole moment than chloroform? It is one of the important question. Why it has, even though fluorine has high electronegativity, even though fluorine contains, are fluorine having high electronegativity, but it has less dipole moment? The reason for this is due to back bond formation. So due to that back bond formation, ability of fluorine is more as compared to chlorine, bromine and iodine. They does not gives any back bond formation, but fluorine due to shorter bond distance, they donates lone pair of electron towards partial positive charge of carbon. Due to the back bond formation of these fluorines, your polarities decreases. As the polarities decreases, dipole moment is also decreases. And acidic nature. Acidic nature is also mainly depends on that dipole moment. So which is more acidic in nature in this case? Same. chloroform having more acidic in nature. Why? Because this hydrogen is more acidic in nature. Chlorines are strong electron withdrawing group. So due to that electron withdrawing nature, this carbon having more positive charge, this carbon having when more positive charge, it attracts the shared pair of electron from that hydrogen and it gives that H plus ion easily. So it is more acidic in nature. So acidic character is also same, similar to that of dipole moment. Chloroform is greater than fluoroform, is greater than bromoform, is greater than iodoform. Chloroform having more acidic in nature. Now, in that methane, as the number of carbon chlorine atoms are increases, dipole moment is decreases. For example, methyl chloride is there, dichloromethane is there, trichloromethane is there, carbon tetrachloride is there. So what is the dipole moment order? Dipole moment order. So dipole moment order, chloromethane having more dipole moment than dichloromethane, dichloromethane having more dipole moment than trichloromethane, and carbon tetrachloride having almost zero dipole moment. Here, now see the comparison in between methyl chloride and carbon tetrachloride. So in that methyl chloride, all the bond momentums are takes place in same direction. All the bond momentums are takes place in same direction. It is having somewhat distorted tetrahedral structure, but carbon tetrachloride having exactly tetrahedral structure. So in this case, bond momentum is takes place from lower electronegative to higher electronegative, and hydrogen to carbon. Here also hydrogen to carbon. So in this case, all the bond momentums are takes place in same direction. So it is having high dipole moment. It is having high dipole moment. In this case, carbon to chlorine, here carbon to chlorine. So this value is cancelled by this value, and this value is cancelled by this value. So dipole moment value is zero. Here carbon tetrachloride, due to that symmetrical structure, it has zero dipole moment, and methyl chloride, in this case, all the bond momentums are takes place in same direction. So it is having more dipole moment. So this is about that dipole moment order and acidic nature. Bases attacks. Here bases attacks on carbon. Now this bases attacks, this nucleophile is attacks on carbon, and chlorine is removed in the form of Cl minus. In further step, this bond is shifted towards this, and chlorine is removed in the form of Cl minus. CH double bond oxygen. In that way, aldehyde is obtained. So this reaction. So that will be explained like this. Your OH is act as a nucleophile. When OH is attacks on halogen containing carbon, and your chlorine is removed, OH is added. So after that, proton is removed and Cl minus is removed, then we can obtain aldehydes. Next, go for that carbyl amine reaction. Carbyl amine. It is one of the important. Why? Because this test is used for the identification of chloroform, and it is also used for the identification of primary amines. This test is given by only aliphatic and aromatic amines, primary amines, or NH2. When it is reacts with chloroform in presence of KOH, alkyl isocyanide we can obtain. Alkyl isocyanide we can obtain. 3 moles of KCl. 3 moles of H2. Isocyanide, it is having bad odor, often smell, so due to that smell it is identified. Now see the mechanism. This mechanism also takes place through carbene. Now how the carbene is formed, just we discuss, again we will discuss how the carbene is obtained. So first of all, formation of carbene. Here base is there, when base is attacks on chloroform, it is one of the best example for that, alpha elimination or 1-1 elimination. So what is the compound we can obtain? Dichloromethylene we can obtain. So this bracket indicates that vacant orbital, it is indicates that lone pair of electron. It means due to the presence of vacant orbital, it acts as a electrophile. Due to the presence of lone pair of electron, it acts as a nucleophile. NH2 is there. This NH2 is act as a, whatever it may be, aliphatic or NH2. It acts as a nucleophile. It attacks on carbene. Or NH positive charge. Chlorine negative charge. It undergoes dehydrohalogenation further. We can obtain R triple bond or N triple bond C. Isocyanide we can obtain. So this is about that carbyl amine test. So what is the use of this carbyl amine test? Uses of this carbyl amine test, it is used for the identification of chloroform, and it is also used for the identification of primary amines. Only primary amines gives this reaction, and chloroform gives this reaction, not carbon tetrachloride. So it is used for the distinguishing of chloroform from carbon tetrachloride, and it is used for the identification of primary amines from secondary and tertiary amines. It is one of the most important reaction, carbyl amine reaction. It is used for the identification of chloroform and also used for the identification of primary amines. Next go for that condensation reaction. Condensation reaction. What is condensation reaction? When acetone reacts with chloroform in presence of KOH, we can obtain chloritone. This chloritone is used as a hypnotic drug. This chloritone is used as a hypnotic drug. So what is the IUPAC nomenclature of this compound? The numbering starts from this carbon, 1, 2, 3. So 1-1-1 trichloro 2 methyl 2 propanol. It is IUPAC nomenclature of this compound. How it is obtained? Now see the mechanism for this reaction. Mechanism. So first of all, formation of nucleophile. Formation of nucleophile. when bases attacks on chloroform, it removes the proton and a nucleophile is obtained. Attacking of nucleophile. Acetone, when it is reacts with nucleophile, this nucleophile is attacks on carbonyl carbon, these pi electrons are shifted towards the oxygen. So what is the compound we can obtain? CH3 O negative charge, CCl3 CH3, then followed by protonation we can obtain chloritone. Chloritone is used as a hypnotic drug. Now let us go for that uses of chloroform. What are the uses of chloroform? Chloroform is used as a anesthesia. So in olden days it is used as a anesthesia, but nowadays due to that adverse effect it is not used as a anesthesia, and it is used as a solvent for most of the organic compounds. It is also used as a preservative for biological specimens. Chloritone, just we discussed, chloritone is used as a hypnotic drug. And chloropicrin is also considered as a tear gas. It is also considered as a tear gas. Three more reactions are left in chloroform. Now let us discuss one by one. Chloroform, when it is subjected to base hydrolysis, what is the compound we can obtain? We know that all the three chlorine atoms is replaced by OH group. We know that if the carbon contains more than one OH groups, it is highly unstable, so it undergoes dehydration. So due to that dehydration, what is the compound we can obtain? Your formic acid we can obtain. So due to the formation of formic acid, Dumas gave the name chloroform. This formic acid is further reacts with NaOH, so sodium formate we can obtain, HCOONa plus H2. Sodium formate we can obtain. This is reaction. Second one is reaction with ethyl alcohol. When chloroform reacts with ethyl alcohol, your hydrogen and chlorines are removed in the form of HCl, then ethyl ortho formate we can obtain. Ethyl ortho formate. Ethyl ortho formate use. And chloroform is also involves in ring expansion reaction. Let us see the example for that ring expansion. In ring expansion, in ring expansion reaction, when ferrol reacts with chloroform in presence of KOH, three chloropyridine is obtained. Now see the mechanism for this reaction. It is involves in ring expansion. 5-membered ring get converted into 6-membered ring. It is considered as a ring expansion. It is also one of the best example for that ring expansion reaction. Now see the mechanism carefully. So first of all, chloroform reacts with base. This reaction is also takes place through the formation of carbene. H2O. Here one of the vacant orbital is present and one of the lone pair of electron is present. It means it acts as an electrophile and as well as nucleophile. When it is reacts with pyrrole, so this lone pair of electron is attacks on this carbon, these pi electrons are attacks on this carbon. This is the compound we can obtain. In that next step, this bond is shifted towards this. At the same time, chlorine is removed in the form of Cl minus. So here 5 member ring get converted into 6 member ring. Your 6 member ring is obtained. Here chlorine, the bond is shifted from this carbon. So this carbon having positive charge, here the double bonds are formed. Then in the next step, this hydrogen is more acidic in nature, so it gives shared pair of electron towards the ring and removed in the form of H plus ion. So this is the compound we can obtain. 3 chloro pyridine we can obtain. 5 member ring get converted into 6 member ring. So it is one of the best example for ring expansion.